Welcome to episode 47 of the Clarity Compressed podcast. My name is Paul J. Daly. I'm excited to be with you this week. This week, we're going to talk about you get to choose.
Of course, the choice is yours.
You can get with this or you can get with that. You can get with this or you can get with that.
And when I say you get to choose, I'm going to do something I haven't done before. And I'm going to break out this book. It's called Discipline Equals Freedom by Jocko Willink. He also wrote this other book over here called Extreme Ownership, probably more well-known by that New York Times bestseller. Got a great podcast. But in the spirit of that podcast, let's go to the book, and I'm going to read my opening statement from here. The book says, people are not who you want them to be. Kill your idols. Sure, there are things that we can learn from people, but people aren't going to be what you think they are or what they should be. People, even those people you have put up on a pedestal, are going to be faulted, weak, egomaniacal, condescending. They're going to be lazy, entitled, short-sighted. They will not be perfect. Far from it. And that's fine. Learn from their weaknesses, of course. Learn from their strengths and mimic and copy them in what they do well. But equally as important, learn from their faults. See what not to do. And here we get into the meat of it. Because you can't control other people. You can't make them what you want them to be. You can't make them who you want them to be. The only person you can control is you. So focus on making yourself who you want to be. Faster, stronger, smarter, more humble, less ego. Discipline your body, free your mind, get up early and go. Get after it and you will become the person you want to be. And you become that person through one small decision at a time. You get to choose. And that's something that I've talked about before, and I'm going to talk about that in a business sense, in a parental sense, in a relationship sense. And the essence of what Jocko's saying in the book, the essence of what I am about and internally want to be about and want to encourage you to be about and think we need to be about as business leaders, entrepreneurs, as spouses, parents, significant others, all of these things, coworkers, bosses, you name it. It is the fact that you own you. People are going to do things that disappoint you. They're going to let you down. You're going to wish they were different. You're going to try to change them. And you can't control that. And the more you try to control that, the more disappointed you get because you can't control other people. But the good news is that you always get to control one person, and that's yourself. You get to control your reactions. You get to control your temper. You get to control the results because you get to control the inputs. So let me talk about business for a second, and I've struggled with this myself. I fight it. It's tempting, right, to blame other people, right? You want to blame other people for the results that you're getting or that something isn't working. But the best leaders, they raise their hand and they say, it's my fault. Everything that happens below me on the chain, however that might be, is my fault. Actually, that's a topic that Jocko talks about in this first book called Extreme Ownership. And I highly recommend you pick it up. The point is, a leader says it's my fault. First, what could I have done to change the outcome? If I'm unsatisfied with it, guess what? What could I have done? And when you take that posture in that position, it does something to your mind so that now it's controllable. It does something to your psyche when you approach situations and you don't want to blame everyone else for your discontentment with a situation, or that the results weren't right, or the client's not happy, or the sales numbers are down, or your operational profits are low, you're not getting the hires that you want, people are leaving. You set the tone, you get to choose, you control you. That's the point. If you're married, guess what? You can't control them. I have spent, and still do, and my wife can vouch for this, spend time trying to control her outcomes or the tendencies that she has. And first of all, I'll say this very publicly. I'm sorry, babe. I want to do better. because I do. And at some point, she'll be able to tell you whether or not I did or I try. But I want to try why. I talked to one of my mentors. He's in his 70s. And he said, you know, my marriage got so much better about 30 years in when I stopped trying to change her. Right? Don't make them the source of your discontentment in relationships. Don't we do that all the time? I don't feel good. It must be your fault. Guess what? That's a bunch of crap. If you're a parent, right, and you see your kids doing things that you don't like or you're not happy with, guess what? Look at yourself. How are you parenting them? Man, I'll tell you what, whenever I see kids in a store or see them freaking out in a public place, see them holding their parents hostage because they didn't get the cupcake and they're going to throw a fit until they get the cupcake, do I say, that's a really crappy kid? Like, that kid is, that's just a bad kid. I don't. It's easy to say that because, man, that kid, and then as they get older, right, that's a really rude 11-year-old, right? Or that's a really selfish 15-year-old. Guess what I think? And I think is the real issue is, like, that's crappy parenting. That hostage situation that I'm witnessing right now has nothing to do with that kid. It has everything to do with what they're used to and what they're conditioned to doing. So when your kid flips out as a parent, think, oh, I guess what, I get to choose how I approach this, and I probably had something to do with the way this kid's acting. Just putting it out there, not judging him, just putting it out there. My kids do things that I realize are my fault. So I thought coming off the week where we talked about resolutions, it was a great time to talk about personal ownership and the fact that we can choose and we can focus on us. Now, granted, some things we can't control. Sometimes we get in a fender bender. Sometimes somebody does something outrageous, right? I'm not saying that everything is your fault because there's some things that aren't, but it's a mindset, right? Yes, there are exceptions, and no, you're not one of them is typically my answer. So I hope that the week after New Year's resolutions or everybody's, you know, all in on those. I hope the week after that, like, this little reminder of you get to choose. And if we're starting the year in our businesses and we're just getting into those new budgets and those new initiatives, right? If you're a leader in the business, wherever you are, right? Take ownership. Make it your fault, right? Make it your responsibility and accountability in your relationships. Make it your responsibility, not their responsibility. When you're a parent, make it your responsibility, not the kid's responsibility. And I think when we do that, the clarity in that situation is that we now actually have a lot more control than we thought. And when we take those excuses away and we suffocate the crap out of them, well, then actually we start to grow because situations get better. So that's kind of it for this week. Just wanted to give you a quick shot of going in. I know you see I got my Eagles hat here. I show Instagram. I got my Eagles hat. By the time you see this podcast, I will be really excited at the fact that they won in the playoff game, or I'll be really disappointed that they lost. I actually probably won't be that disappointed because I grew up on Eagles football, and dang it, Eagles football is about getting disappointed. And every once in a while you win a Super Bowl. Well, that happened last year. So, but am I going to blame the Eagles for my disappointment? No, I'm going to blame myself because I choose to be punished. So that's it. A lot going on this month. A lot of things are ramping up quick. If you're going to be at any of the events that I'm going to be at or speaking at over the next 3 weeks, I hope you reach out so that we can actually connect. I'm going to be at the Mobile Tech Expo in Orlando this week, if you're watching this podcast. And 2 days from now on Thursday, I'm going to be speaking about building your business with a legacy mindset. The following week, I'm going to be in Miami at the Agent 2021 conference. I'm going to be just around on the field. It's at Hard Rock Stadium where the Miami Dolphins play. I'll be out in the field. And I'll also be around, you know, just hanging and learning and talking and meeting with people. The following week after that, I will be at the NADA convention in San Francisco speaking about branding and just reaching out and connecting. If you're going to be at any of those, please reach out. And if you're not connected on any of the social platforms that I post on to interact with, it'd be great if you followed along. Each of them actually has a little bit of a different flavor. So LinkedIn is a lot of business content, and there's a great conversation going on just in general around a lot of the topics. So please connect there. Twitter is, I listen a lot on Twitter, respond to DMs, and post little snippets like you're supposed to. Instagram is a little bit more of a personal side with stories and live streams and things like that. What else? We're doing some stuff on Facebook too, just a good place to connect. So if you're not following, follow on those platforms. Thank you so much for listening and or watching this podcast content. I don't take it for granted. I really appreciate it. My hope in doing all of this is that there'll be some value taken from it that can help you be better in your life, in your business, in your endeavors. And I define value as something that you can deploy immediately. So when you see a piece of content, wherever it is, whether it's mine or somebody else's, I define it, it's valuable if I can immediately take something and internalize or put it into practice. So that's my hope for the Clarity Compressed podcast. That is my hope for you today, this weekend. That is my hope for you, Instagram Live over there. Thank you for checking it out, and we'll post this. We'll repost it probably later. And that's it. Oh, I gotta mention it. We announced our first event that is coming up. We don't know the date yet or exactly the program. It's really infancy stages. It's called ClarityCon 2019. You can go to pursueclarity.com and sign up. The link's in this bio. That's it. Gonna let you go. If you're driving to work, if you're working out, whenever you're listening to this podcast or watching it, I hope you have a great day. And I hope you take ownership. Take the good news that you get to choose. You can get with this, or you can get with that.